Hello everyone, I'm Dr. Prapanna, a practicing hair restoration surgeon at Iife Cosmetics and Hair Implantation in Kormangala, Bangalore. The cause of androgenetic hair loss is the same for all men, that is men whose hair loss is not caused by an underlying medical condition, drugs or stress. There is significant variation in the age at which men start to go bald, as well as the extent of their balding. This wide variability is due to the fact that the expression of androgenetic hair loss is significantly affected by three related factors, that is genes, hormones, and the age. Now let's discuss the role of genes in hair loss. Many people have heard that hair loss comes from the mother's side of the family, but it is largely a myth. While there is a slightly higher frequency in inheritance from the mother's side, male pattern hair loss is a genetic trait that can be inherited from either parent. Research suggests that it is a polygenic trait involving more than one gene and it is much more complicated than originally thought. Now, what's the role of hormones in hair loss? Hormones are biochemical substances produced by various glands located throughout the body. These glands secrete hormones directly into the bloodstream, spreading the chemicals throughout the body. Hormones are very powerful, minute amounts can be profound effects upon your body. Testosterone, the major male sex hormone, and other hormones that have masculinizing effects are made primarily in the testicles. It is not until after the testicles develop and enlarge during puberty that the hormones can reach a level in the bloodstream sufficient to commence the balding process. The hormone left to be directly involved in androgenetic alopecia is a derivative of testosterone called dihydroxytestosterone, also known as DHT. Now, DHT formed by the action of the enzyme 5-alpha reductase on testosterone binds to specific receptor sites on the cells of genetically susceptible hair follicles, causing miniaturization and eventually balding. In men, 5-alpha reductase activity is higher in the balding areas, which leads to the development and patterned hair loss. It typically begins with recession of the hairline and the temples and or thinning in the crown area. It can start as early as adolescence or it can appear later in life. 5-alpha reductase type 2 is the predominant form of hair follicles and is blocked by hair loss, like such as medication with the use of finasteride, also called as propecia. The chemical finasteride binds to 5-alpha reductase molecules, preventing them from converting testosterone into DHT, resulting in decrease in the concentration of DHT levels, which prevents halting and reversal of the miniaturization process. Now, what's the role of age in hair loss? Genes and hormones are not sufficient on their own to cause baldness. Even after a person has reached puberty, susceptible hair follicles must continuously be exposed to DHT over time for hair loss to occur. The age at which these effects manifest varies from one individual to another and is related to the person's genetic composition, the level of testosterone in the bloodstream, and also the follicular sensitivity to the hormone. Additionally, mere hair loss does not occur all at once or is a steadily straight line progression. Instead, it is characteristically irregular, with people losing their hair in alternative periods of slow and rapid hair loss, interspersed between periods of stability. The reasons that hair loss rates speed up and slow down are unknown. But we do know that with age, a person's total hair volume will gradually decrease. Even when there is no predisposition to genetic balding, as a man ages, some hairs in each follicular unit randomly begin to miniaturize. As a result, each group will contain both full terminal hairs and miniaturized hairs, making the hair appear less full. Eventually, the miniaturized hairs are lost and the follicular units are reduced in numbers. In all adult patients, the entire scalp undergoes this aging process, so that even the permanent zone is not truly permanent but will gradually thin to some degree over time. Fortunately, in most men, the permanent zone retains enough permanent hair so that hair transplantation remains a viable option for men well into their 70s.